Hello all, welcome to IQ Pop. So in this lecture I will discuss about data types in C. So there is four kind of basic data types there in C. One is void. Void means it is nothing, it holds nothing, right? So one of the practical example of void in real life, you will find if you look at some electronic product or say your CPU, at the back side of CPU you will find there is a screw on that one sticker is labeled, and it is written that if the sticker is broken, warranty is void. That means what? Once it is broken, the company is not going to provide you the warranty, so it is going to be invalid, right? Yeah. So another kind is integral type. So in integral type there is three kind of things: boolean, character, integer. Next comes floating point. In floating point there is real, imaginary and complex numbers. And another kind of data type is there, that is called derived data type. So what is derived data type? If some data type is newly generated, is created for a special purpose using the basic primitive data types, then that data type will be called as derived data type. So what are the basic data types in C? Char, int, float, double and void. So these are the basic data type in C. So first comes boolean. So boolean was not there in the previous versions or older versions of the C, but it was introduced in C99 version or ANSI C. It belongs to stdio.h standard bool.h header file. It is a object type underscore bool which holds 0 or 1 or true or false as a value. Now in C90, if you want to use bool, then you must have to define it using typedef or enum. So what is typedef and enum? Basically they are used to define new data types in C or user defined data types in C. We'll discuss it later in detail. Now again, see the size of boolean is 1 byte. 1 byte means 1 byte means 8 bits, but we are going to store only 0 or 1, that is 1 bit. So to store 1 bit we are going to use 1 byte in case of boolean. Next is char. So there is two types of char. One is signed char or and another is unsigned char. Char are the data type which holds ASCII characters which is supported by C. So normal char is having size of 1 byte, and 1 byte means 8 bits. Out of 8 bits, 1 bit is going to be used for storing the sign, so it remains 7 bits. So ASCII is encodes the character by 8 bits, 7 bits. So it can hold all the ASCII characters. Next, unsigned char. Unsigned char, 1 byte again, but the 1 byte was used for storing sign. In case of char, that is also going to be used for storing the character bit. So it gets the range 0 to 255 which supports the extended ASCII character, which enables it to store extended ASCII character. Next, signed char. So signed char, here I must say char by default is signed char. Okay, so they both the things are same, this char and signed char. If you write signed char, it doesn't do anything new. It will do same thing what char was doing. Next, integer. So integer are the data types which used to define variables which will hold integer value. So again, the first bit of the integer is going to be used to store the sign of the integer. It may be signed and unsigned, definitely the same way Now there is a short in past. Short in is the type which has shy is of 2 byte. So if it is 2 byte, 1 byte is 8 bit per byte, so it is going to be 16 bits, and 1 bit is used for sign bit, so it is going to be 2 to the power 15 plus minus 2 to the power 15, because 1 bit is used for sign bit. So that bit, sign bit may be 0 or 1. 0 represents plus here, and 1 represents negative here. So 2 to the power 15 becomes or gives this range, positive this number to negative 32767. Now next comes int. Int usually in the current computers you will find the size of int is 4 bytes, but it may be 2 bytes also depending on your computer and processor. So if it is 2 byte, then it will be have the same range like short int. If it is 4 byte, then here it will become 4. This place it will be 4, like long int. So in long int it is 4 byte. Again, out of 4 byte, 1 bit or first bit is going to be used for storing the sign bit. So it is going to be 32 minus 1, 31 bit is going to use to store the integer. So the range becomes this. Long int is also there, which can be of 8 byte. So size becomes 64 minus 1, 2 to the power 63 bits. So which can able to hold the range of this integer. So again, another thing, this plus minus can be removed if you write unsigned int everywhere. So in that case, this range will be simply double for each case. So 1 bit extra we will get. So 1 bit extra at the most significant digit, a bit in binary, means that the number going to be doubled. Floating point number. So number with a decimal point we call it as floating point number. So float is the data type. So in most of the computer system, float is defined as a 4 byte, or it is having a size of 4 byte with this range. If it is 4 byte, usually we have 6 digit precision in the decimal. And if we need a larger range of floating point number, then we can use double, which is having 8 byte of range, and we can have long double also, which may have 8 byte of range. With in case of double, it is 10 or 15 digit precision. In case of long double, the precision may increase up to 21 bit of precision. Now, how floating point numbers are going to be stored in the memory? So if it is a 4 byte we are speaking about, so first bit, again it is going to store the sign bit. Okay, 1 bit is for sign, yes. 8 bit is for exponent, storing the exponent. 23 bits are going to be used to store the mantissa or fraction part. Okay, so in binary the representation looks like this. The 1 bit, it may be 0 or 1 for sign bit, and 1 hidden bit is there for fraction part, mantissa part. That is every time the first bit of mantissa part is going to be 1. This is fixed for all the cases. Okay, so we write 1f dot 2 to the power the exponent. Okay, so this is going to be the representation. And if we convert this thing to decimal, we will get again the sign bit, then 1f dot 10 to the power exponent. So what is the range we are going to have? 1f into 2 to the power minus 127 to plus 128, or in case of decimal it is almost equivalent to 1 into 10 to the power plus minus 32. So mantis f has hidden bit, I have already told you, so it is going to be 24 bit actually, but I have written here, you can see 23 bit and 1 bit by default is going to be added. So it can give you maximum 7 significant figure. Now exponent e is biased by 127. It is very important to remember, because when we will convert from this binary to decimal, because in memory it is going to be stored in binary form, and when we are going to display it on the screen or when we are going to use it, is going to be used as decimal number. So we need to convert this thing to decimal, so it is biased by 127 bit. We need to remember it. This is the range of the exponents. Now go to next. Here is one example. Say plus 111011 dot 4 times 0 1 3 times 0 is an example of 16 bit fixed point number. So this is equivalent to this is in 7.8 format. Okay. And here you can see another example is there, 41.4. If the position is 1, that is decimal or significant digit is 1. Now go for another example. Say take a decimal number, say 5777. This is 10 representing it is in decimal number, and we need to convert this to floating point. So step 1 is convert the decimal number simply to binary. So 5777, if we convert to binary, we will get 10110100 3 times 0 1. That is 13 bits. So it is positive number, so sign bit will be 0. So in representation, we will put 0 at the beginning. Next, step 2, count number of places to move binary point. So how many places we can move? So we have 13 bits, so we can move up to 12 bit. Okay, so we can write it like this: 1 point, the remaining 12 bits into the power 12, because we have moved 12 bits. Okay, now it is we have seen that it is biased by 127, exponent is biased by 127, so we will add 127 to this 12, so we will get 139 in decimal, right? Now again this, you convert this 139 to binary, so we get this is as exponent. Now exponent will be stored in the exponent part, no problem, and mantissa will store here. And but we have how many bits in mantissa? 12 bits. So but we need to store here 23 bits. So we store this 12 bit first, then we store remaining bits, or we stop the remaining bits with zeros. So this is the way of representing floating point number in memory. So here is a comparison between float and double. In float we get 32 bit binary, and in double you get 64 bit binary. Okay, so there is a size difference. It can be divided into three part. It also can be divided into three part in the same way. 1 bit is used for sign. Here also 1 bit is used for sign. Exponent is 8 bit here, but here exponent is going to be 11 bits. Okay, now significant precision here 23 bits, here 52 bits. So here the difference reflects. Now here are the list of format specifier, and I have highlighted few of the popular or widely used format specifier. So first one is %c, we use for character, we have seen in our previous example. %d we use for integer, we have seen our previous example or coding part. %f is used for floating point number, we have also used this one. %l is for signed integer. Okay, so like this LU for unsigned integer, we can use it. Percent %p we have used to display address. Percent %u is unsigned integer, again we have used. Okay, so all these things I have used, and they have the list. So when we will need, accordingly we will choose from here and we will use in our code. Thank you for watching. Like, comment, share and subscribe, and stay with me to get more lecture on C and other topics.